Yo, what is going on, Fantasy Addicts? I'm your host, That Fantasy Addict, and today, this is marking the very beginning of a new series on my channel. I don't know what the title is going to be called, so this might not be in the title, but if it's not, just know that this series is going to be called Wide Receiver ADPs That Make Absolutely No Sense, and this is episode one of that series. So, what is this series going to be? Sort of self-explanatory, but basically in each one of these episodes, we will be diving deep into one wide receiver who has an ADP that makes absolutely no sense at all. I asked you guys on Twitter if this is a series that would interest you, and the majority of you guys said absolutely. So I'm bringing this series to you guys, and in case for some reason you don't follow me on Twitter, well, you definitely should, because first of all, you get to choose what kind of videos I make. If you were following me on Twitter and you saw that poll, your vote would certainly count. You could have said you wanted this series to happen, or you could have said you don't like it at all. Also, if you're not following me on Twitter, then you don't have the chance to be in any of my videos, because if you saw yesterday's video, you would know that it was a mock draft with 11 other subscribers and followers on my Twitter and YouTube account. So if you're not following me on Twitter, unfortunately, you can't be in any of those mock draft videos. You also have to be subscribed to me here, so do both if you want to be in one of my mock draft videos. And not to mention, I will be doing giveaways soon, and those will be happening here on YouTube, but also on Twitter. So if you're not following me on Twitter, I highly suggest that you do, but I'm not going to force you to do anything. If you, for some reason, don't want to take advantage of this lovely opportunity, then I guess you're just missing out, but that's not my business. What my business is to tell you exactly why Michael Gallup's ADP makes absolutely no sense. Let's get right into it. All right, starting out, Michael Gallup was the wide receiver 17 last season in PPR scoring in terms of points per game. So he missed a few games due to injury, but if we just look at points per game, which is a much better way to analyze a player's fantasy production rather than total points scored, we can see that he was a solid and actually high-end wide receiver too last season. So what is going to change this upcoming season for Michael Gallup? Well, a new head coach is in town, Mike McCarthy. Now, since Mike McCarthy's arrival in Green Bay in 2006, his second leading receiver in terms of targets, his second leading receiver every single season has never had less than 84 targets. That is very, very impressive considering he has done this for so, so long. A decade and a half, and he has never had his wide receiver two with less than 84 targets. That is very, very impressive. Now, Mike McCarthy also has not had the most talent at the wide receiver position either. James Jones was his most common wide receiver too, and he's not the most talented wide receiver there is. Michael Gallup is, in my opinion, definitely more talented than James Jones. If we look at when McCarthy actually had a good wide receiver too, like Michael Gallup, we can see that Randall Cobb in 2014 had 127 targets. Randall Cobb was the wide receiver two on that team, and he was pretty good. He had 127 targets, which is a very good amount. Also, Devontae Adams in 2016 was the wide receiver two for that team. Now, I know you're thinking Devontae Adams is a lot better than Michael Gallup, for now at least, but remember, this is 2016 Devontae Adams, and at that time, Devontae Adams was nowhere near as accomplished as he is now. That season, he had 127 targets, and he converted that into less than 1,000 yards. So that just shows you he wasn't who he is now. Prior to this 2016 season, he had actually never broken 500 yards, and even in that 2016 season, he failed to break 1,000 yards. So that just shows you that Devontae Adams was not the Devontae Adams we know and love now. So don't go commenting, oh, well, Devontae Adams is so much better than Michael Gallup, because while that may be true now, it wasn't back then. 2016 Davante Adams is pretty comparable to current Michael Gallup. Also, in those 2014 and 2016 seasons, the leading target was Jordy Nelson, who is certainly better than the Cowboys wide receiver one, Amari Cooper. Jordy Nelson had 151 and 152 targets in 2014 and 2016, which is significantly higher than Amari Cooper's 119 total targets in 2019, and even significantly higher than his season high in targets of 132 in 2016, which was back in Oakland. Not only is Gallup, in my opinion, better than 2014 Cobb and 2016 Davante Adams, but Cooper is definitely not as good as 2014 and 2016 Jordy Nelson, which means that, if anything, Gallup could easily have more targets than Cobb did in 2014 and Adams in 2016. I'm not saying that it's going to happen, but it certainly is a possibility. Also, the Cowboys are second in the NFL in vacated targets with 190. So even if you think that CeeDee Lamb's presence is that scary and that he's going to be so good, just remember that those 190 vacated targets will certainly take care of Lamb, and it will provide extra targets to go around the team. There's no way that CeeDee Lamb has 190 targets. That is just not humanly possible. It's not going to happen. Also, in 2014, the third wide receiver in targets was the rookie Davante Adams. And in 2016, the third wide receiver in targets was Randall Cobb. Cobb had 84 targets that season in 2016, and in 2014, Davante Adams had 66 targets. So Mike McCarthy can still have really, really good and borderline elite wide receiver twos on his team while still having a good wide receiver three. He can have those solid wide receiver two seasons even with a good wide receiver three taking a good amount of targets. So Lamb's presence is not that concerning. He might be good, but Mike McCarthy has shown that he can have a good wide receiver three while still providing well over 100 targets to the wide receiver two. Now let's talk about touchdowns. In case touchdowns are a concern for you, they really should not be at all. Remember, Michael Gallup last season in PPR scoring in points per game was the wide receiver 17 amongst all wide receivers. He only scored 6 touchdowns, and honestly, he should see some positive touchdown regression. He saw just 2 10 zone targets all season, and they were both in the last 5 games of the season. They clearly started to use him more when it mattered most, all the way inside the 10-yard line as the season went on and as he showed time after time that he is capable of absolutely producing. They also began using him more in the red zone as a whole as the season went on. In the last 5 games of the season, Gallup saw 4 total red zone targets. Also, in the last 10 games of the season, he saw 7 red zone targets. But in his first 4 games played last season, he saw just 1 red zone target. That is not a lot, and they clearly started to use him more in the red zone and 10 zone as the season went on, and that should continue into 2020. Not to mention, 4 of his 6 total touchdowns last season actually came outside of the red zone, so he was not reliant on red zone opportunities at all, but they will certainly help if he gets more opportunities in the red zone this upcoming season. But guess what? He's still not reliant on them. He can produce even without, and he does have decent speed and therefore is always a threat to break away for a touchdown from over 20 yards out. Also, keep in mind that all of his production last season was him as a second-year wide receiver who tore his meniscus in week 2. He is now a third-year wide receiver, which is when wide receivers have the best chance of breaking out historically. He should also be fully recovered from that meniscus tear, so not only is he in this stage of his career where the numbers show that he has the greatest chance of breaking out, but also he shouldn't be dealing with that torn meniscus this upcoming season, so he should certainly be a lot more efficient and just a much better receiver overall in 2020 than he was last season in 2019. Let's go back to the coaching. Mike McCarthy, new head coach in town, he likes to pass the ball a lot. While Jason Garrett has adapted to the pass recently, he still clearly enjoys to run the ball more. That is what he enjoys most, and he wants that to be the core of his offense. McCarthy has never favored the run, and he has always loved to pass the ball. The Cowboys should throw it more under Mike McCarthy than they did under Jason Garrett, especially considering all the talent that they have on the offensive side. And you know what? Let's go look at what happened recently with Mike McCarthy. So, up until 2019, McCarthy was the head coach in Green Bay for about 15 years. But last season, the Green Bay Packers, under Matt LaFleur, instead of under Mike McCarthy, they actually ran the ball over 400 times for the first time since 2015. Clearly, Mike McCarthy always had the talent at running back, but he just never used running backs as they should have been used. Eddie Lacy, yeah, he became overweight, but Aaron Jones is great, and he thrived under Matt LaFleur, but not under Mike McCarthy. And if you think that them running the ball 400 times this season for the first time since 2015, if you think that was just because the Packers were really good this season, so they were just naturally inclined to run the ball, while at first glance that actually may seem like a pretty good point, the thing is that we can go look at some other Packers teams under Mike McCarthy and see what happened there. So in 2016, the Packers went 10-6. Keep in mind, this was also the season where Devontae Adams, as the Packers wide receiver too, had 121 targets. So this is a pretty good team to compare with the current Cowboys roster, especially because this was a pretty good Packers team and the Cowboys should be a pretty good team as well. So in this season, Rodgers threw it 620 times for over 4,400 yards, which was fourth in the NFL, and 40 touchdowns, which was first in the entire NFL. They also ran it less than 400 times that season. What's that? You think that the Cowboys are going to be better than 10-6? Okay, how about we go look at the 2014 Packers, who went 12-4. This is the season where Randall Cobb, as the Packers wide receiver too, saw 127 targets. So once again, another good season to compare to the current Cowboys roster, and likely a winning team. So in that season, in 2014, the Packers did run it over 400 times, 435 to be exact. But that's nothing crazy. They were nearly league average that season in rushing attempts. And if we look at passing, Rodgers threw 38 touchdowns that season, which ranked fourth in the NFL. And he threw for nearly 4,400 yards, which was seventh in the NFL. So all in all, Mike McCarthy has always loved to pass the ball. Even when his teams were great, and especially when he has a solid wide receiver too, which Gallup certainly is. So, now let's just go through a quick summary and really compare the differences between the 2019 Cowboys and 2019 Michael Gallup versus 2020 Cowboys and 2020 Michael Gallup. So, to start off our comparison, in 2020, there are 190 vacated targets, but CeeDee Lamb is now on their team. But considering that we don't even know if Lamb is going to be good in his rookie year, because remember, most wide receivers do struggle in their rookie season, just because of that, I'm sure that the presence of CeeDee Lamb will at least cancel out the 190 vacated targets in this offense, but I'm sure that the 190 vacated targets are actually going to heavily outweigh Lamb's presence, because obviously there's no way that CeeDee Lamb as a rookie is going to get 190 targets. There is just no way that that is ever going to happen. And honestly, if anything, Lamb is going to force defenses to take some pressure off of Gallup if they have to decide between taking off pressure from Amari Cooper or Michael Gallup to put it on CeeDee Lamb. I guarantee you they are going to take some pressure off of Michael Gallup to put that on CeeDee Lamb, because at the end of the day, Amari Cooper still is the wide receiver one on this team, so defenses are going to want to cover Amari Cooper a little more heavily than Michael Gallup or CeeDee Lamb. So in this targets category, we'll call it, 2020 definitely takes the win over 2019. Now, let's look at coaching. Mike McCarthy versus Jason Garrett. Like we said before, Jason Garrett, while he has been adapting to the passing game more recently, Mike McCarthy loves to pass the ball no matter what. We already looked at 2014 and 2016 Packers, and they are pretty similar to the current Cowboys roster. And we saw those Packer teams love to pass the ball. They scored a lot of passing touchdowns. And we just know that Mike McCarthy loves to pass the ball. So for fantasy football, at least, and from a wide receiver's perspective, especially from Michael Gallup's perspective for fantasy football, Mike McCarthy in 2020 definitely takes the win over 2019 Jason Garrett. Now we're going to look at specifically Michael Gallup's experience in 2019 versus 2020. So in 2019, he was a second-year wide receiver. In 2020, he is a third-year wide receiver. While some second-year wide receivers do break out, it is much more common for a third-year wide receiver to break out. And even if they do break out in their second season, they typically have a better season in their third year anyway. They just don't take as big of a leap going into their third season as they did going into their second season, if that second season was their breakout year. But even though Michael Gallup certainly was very good in his second season, it wasn't a complete breakout season. It wasn't a wide receiver one season, but his third season is definitely where we could see that. And no matter what, he has more experience going into this upcoming season, and he is now about to enter his prime at just a little over 24 years old. Player Profiler lists him at 24.3 years of age right here, and I will leave a link in the description below to Player Profiler if you would like to visit this website. It's a great website. They have a lot of different metrics. Player Profiler is what you're looking at right now. That is the website. Once again, link in the description below. So back to the experience. Since being a third-year wide receiver is pretty much always better than being a second-year wide receiver, especially if you didn't completely break out in your second year and be a top 6, 8, 10, maybe 12 fantasy wide receiver, then being a third-year wide receiver is always, always a better situation than being a second-year wide receiver. So Michael Gallup, being a third-year wide receiver in 2020, takes the win over being a second-year wide receiver in 2019. Finally, we're going to look at health status and injuries. Of course, we don't know if he's going to get injured or not this season. So to start, we're just going to look at what we know right now. He is not dealing with an injury right now, and he should start the season healthy. We also know that unless he tears his meniscus again, which is unlikely, then he is not going to have to deal with the torn meniscus throughout the season like he did in 2019. We also know that he missed a few weeks last season, and of course, we don't know if he's going to miss a few weeks this upcoming season, but we have no evidence to prove that he's going to miss a few weeks, and all in all, there is absolutely no reason to show that his performance should be affected by his torn meniscus last season. But we do know that his performance was hindered a little bit last season by that torn meniscus in week 2. So health status in 2020 takes the win over health status in 2019. So with all that being said, remember how he was in PPR scoring in points per game, the wide receiver 17 last season? Well, what do you think his PPR ADP is right now? You're probably thinking maybe wide receiver 12, wide receiver 13, because he'll take a little bit of a jump. It's definitely a better situation, and he certainly has the potential to be a top 6 wide receiver, but it wouldn't make much sense to have him being drafted over guys like Tyreek Hill, over Chris Godwin, guys who have already broken out, right? So wide receiver 10, 12, 13, something like that makes sense, right? Well, no, that's wrong. Now you might be thinking wide receiver 15, 16, because it can't be worse or even equal to what he was last season, because clearly the situation is a lot better, right? Well, still wrong. He is worse than what he was last season in PPR points per game. Doesn't make any sense. But now, make another guess. You're probably thinking wide receiver 20, wide receiver 21. You're still wrong. Even lower. I know you're thinking that he has to be wide receiver two, considering that he almost finished as a wide receiver one in PPR points per game last season, right? Incorrect. He is not even going as a wide receiver two in PPR scoring ADP. It doesn't make any sense. But let's keep going. Now you're definitely thinking that he has to be at least a flex, right? Which there isn't a firm number that makes someone being drafted as a flex, because obviously there's 12 wide receiver one slots in the entire league and 12 wide receiver two slots in the entire league. So therefore, top 12 wide receivers in ADP are going as wide receiver ones. Then 13 to 24 are going as wide receiver twos. So you might think that it's wide receiver 25 to wide receiver 36 is a flex, but just remember, you can start running back, tight end, or wide receiver. But I like to think that about 8 of the 12 flexes will be wide receivers just because they're safer. So I like to think that a top 32 wide receiver is going as a flex, but you could say top 30. But either way, it doesn't matter because Michael Gallup is not in the top 30 or the top 32 in PPR ADP. His PPR ADP per fantasydata.com, which I will leave a link to in the description below if you'd like to check it out. Per fantasydata.com's PPR ADP, Michael Gallup is going as the wide receiver 33. This makes no sense at all. I want you guys to comment below, and I'm sure that most of you guys are now convinced that Michael Gallup's ADP is an absolute steal. But what I want you to do now in the comments below is tell me one thing that is even anything close to being bad for Michael Gallup. It doesn't have to prove why Michael Gallup should be going as the wide receiver 33, because I don't think anything will prove that. But just find one thing that is bad about Michael Gallup. I want to hear it, because I don't really personally think that anything is bad about Michael Gallup. I can't even find anything that suggests anything negative about Michael Gallup in 2020. So if you agree with me and you think that there is absolutely nothing that suggests anything bad for Michael Gallup in 2020, let me know in the comments below. But if you can think of something, then leave it in the comments below, because I would like to know, because even though I have a pretty firm belief that Michael Gallup's ADP as the wide receiver 33 is a complete steal, I do want to hear your guys' opinions, because who knows, maybe you will change my opinion, or at the very least, give a little bit of awareness to me and make me calm down a little bit on Michael Gallup's ADP, because I truthfully don't get it. So let me know in the comments below, do you A, agree with me and not think that there is a single thing that suggests anything bad for Michael Gallup, or B, do you actually think that there is something that is a little bad about Michael Gallup? And if so, what is it? Thank you guys so much for watching. I really appreciate you staying throughout this entire video if you are still watching at this point. If you are, clearly you enjoyed the video. So definitely hit that subscribe button and turn on the bell icon, because if you want to get notifications of all my videos, that is the only way to get them. So if you like this content, then make sure to stay tuned and keep watching all my daily videos, because I put out videos every single day so you guys can dominate your draft and dominate the waiver wire, dominate trades, everything like that. I'm still going to be making videos throughout the season, so definitely stay tuned there. Also, I tweet multiple times every single day, giving out content. So if you're not following me on Twitter, first of all, just follow me for the content. But also, obviously, I will be doing giveaways soon. If you're following me there, you will have a chance of joining my mock drafts with you guys. And also, you'll be able to decide what kind of videos I do at times. So definitely a lot of reasons to follow me over there. And thank you guys so much. Please drop a like if you enjoyed this video, because it really, really does help small YouTubers like myself. I can't stress it enough. It really helps us grow our channel and everything like that. So that's the least that you guys could do to just show your appreciation for this video. And it's free to do. So I'm not asking you to spend any money. I'm just asking you to take 2 seconds out of your day to go hit that like button and show your appreciation for my effort making this video to help you guys with your draft. And I guess I've said everything that I need to say. thank you for tuning in to Wide Receiver ADPs That Make Absolutely No Sense, episode one. Not going to tell you yet who's going to be episode two, but it definitely is going to be a really, really good one. Stay tuned for that, and I will see you guys next time. Peace.